How do you clean a menstrual cup? We're gonna go over all of it. The sanitizing in public. Can you use a bidet? All of those questions we're covering today. Welcome back to the Period Nirvana channel. My name is Kim Rosas and I am a cup educator and have been for almost 10 years. So if there's a question about cups, chances are I've heard it before and hopefully know the answer. If you're new here and just found out about Period Nirvana, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Now let's talk about cleaning your menstrual cup. A lot of people have some trepidation about switching to cups because they're worried about germs and bacteria, and is it something that's safe and healthy? Because previously, for those of us using tampons, it was a disposable option. You didn't have to worry about sanitizing it for the next use. So it makes sense, okay, how do I keep this product from introducing bacteria into my body and not being smelly and things like that? So we're gonna cover, I think, all the bases, hopefully, in today's video. And if you are just looking for answers for a very specific part of the cleaning process, I have placed chapters with titles in this video, so you can skip ahead to the question that you have if you don't need any of the other information. But hopefully you'll just enjoy listening to the soothing sounds of my southern accent. So first, let's just start with the routine of cleaning your cup. So if you're new to cups and wondering how this all works, you can safely wear a menstrual cup up to 12 hours before needing to wash it, to clean it, to remove it. So you don't want to keep your cup in longer than 12 hours. You want to, 12 hours or less, remove the cup. And that's when you're going to dump the contents, you're going to wash it, and you're going to replace it. And in that process, there are some options that you as the wearer have. Once you have gotten to the sink and you're washing your cup, you can do a couple of things. You can use a cup safe wash. And the benefit of a cup safe wash is that you don't have to do the math, so to speak. You don't have to look at the ingredients list and say, okay, you know, is all of this safe for silicone? Is all of this safe for, you know, sensitive vulva tissue? So you do still want to fully rinse off your cup with of all of the soap, because in some cases people have had reactions and they thought, you know, and I've fielded these troubleshooting questions quite often, and they'll say, I think I'm allergic to my menstrual cup. And when we've distilled all the issues down, it turns out that the soap they were using, they just weren't rinsing it all the way off. And that was what led to some sensitivity. But if you're super sensitive, you may want to skip the soap altogether. And I know that sounds like, okay, how is it clean? You know, this silicone's not really absorbing things. So just a hot water wash throughout your cycle is okay, in my opinion. And then at the end of your cycle, you can sterilize the cup before the next cycle. So you can either wash it and then put it away, sterilize when your period starts by boiling, or you can sterilize it and then put it away. It doesn't matter which. People ask, do I boil it and then store it, or store it and then boil it when my period starts? I would rather just go ahead and boil it and put it in a breathable pouch, a breathable storage pouch. You don't want airtight, you know, you don't want to put silicone or any of these other menstrual cups in airtight sealed things. So breathable pouch, simple drawstring, most cups come with them, that's fine. When it comes to going and washing at the sink, my favorite tip is this. Fill the cup with your soapy water if you're using cleanser, or just regular water if not, to the brim, put your hand over it, and then in the sink, squeeze, 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 squeeze. This gets anything out of the suction holes, and this is important when you're getting a good seal. If your cup has suction holes, you don't want it to be blocked. So any gunk that's remaining in there, that will be pushed out easily. And additionally, people will get these little interdental bristles and use that if they need to clean out the suction holes. I don't really do that, but if the suction holes look like they need some extra bristling, you can do that. And sometimes even just a regular toothbrush works, obviously one that you're done using on your teeth. Every 12 hours, wash with regular hot water, no soap, or wash with a cup cleanser. You can also use just regular unscented gentle hand soap. You can also just use something like Castile soap. So think about, you know, if you have sensitivities or not, think about what's safe. Again, I just buy cup wash because it's easier for me and I don't have to think about it. Now let's talk a little bit about some other things that might make using a menstrual cup a little bit easier in the cleaning department. I recently upgraded my bathroom to a bidet. And I was thinking this is going to be super cool for menstrual cups because I could use the water stream in the toilet and rinse it, kind of like dump it in the toilet seat and rinse it. It doesn't work so great for cups. And it's kind of like when you put a spoon underneath a faucet. It just has been messier than I expected to try to put it in the bidet stream of water and rinse it. And then it really made more of a mess than it was worth. However, I will add a caveat. If you use a menstrual disc, which I use if I'm not testing products, I like menstrual discs a little bit more than menstrual cups these days. That was actually better with the bidet because menstrual discs, when you remove them, are often covered in blood on the outside as well as the inside. Really just the whole thing is just like really bloody. And so I was able to kind of rinse it off underneath the bidet and this shape worked better with the spray. So then I was able to take some toilet paper and, you know, so it's not dripping wet and making a mess to get to my sink, just do that and then go to my sink and wash it and then put it back in. And the same goes for menstrual cups, kind of segueing into what do you do in that in-between moment? Because not everyone has a sink that's conveniently located next to their toilet. I have what I call my favorite bathroom in the house, which is my toilet is here and a sink is here. And so I literally take a cup or a disc out and I reach over here, I turn the faucet on and I do, you know, this thing. And then I do it all from the toilet. It's quite amazing. But most of us don't have that situation. So what are you gonna do? You end up shuffling to the sink with your pants at your ankles or completely off. Some people take their pants off to do their cup work. I take toilet paper and I just kind of sit the cup on it so it's not dripping with anything. And I go to my sink and I wash it. And then I bring this bloody tissue back and I flush it. And then I put my cup back in and wash my hands. So I'm basically from the toilet, shuffle to the sink, sink, wash, shuffle back, pop it in. So that's my sink isn't next to the toilet method. But what if you're in public? this is one of those, you choose your own adventure with this. Going back to the timing thing, will you have to change your cup in public? One of the big benefits of cups is that you could go up to 12 hours. So in all likelihood, many of you will not have to even think about changing your cup in public because you have 12 hours. You put it in the morning, you go the whole day, you get home, time for bed, you take it out, you wash it, you put it in. If that's not the case for you, if you have a heavier period or something else happens and you need to change in public, here's what I do. I remove my cup, dump it, and just stick it right back in. I don't even bother, some people do this, and I used to, where I just wipe it up, but then I was like, what's the point? Like, it's not cleaning it. It's just, you know, there's no, it's barely out of my body, I just put it right back in. And then I use toilet paper at that point. If there is any blood on my hands, which with cups, usually not, you know, I just take the toilet paper and wipe my fingers, and then that way when I go to the sink, I'm not, you know, covered in any kind of blood. Again, usually not when I remove my cups, discs are different. But yeah, that's how I do it. Now, alternatively, if you know you're gonna be out in public and having to do that, you can bring something like cup wipes. So you take a cup wipe, you open it, you have these with you in your purse. This one's a pretty large one. The Lunette wipes are like tiny. This is more like a baby wipe, which is kind of nice. And then just clean it up. And so this is, you know, it has alcohol in it. You might feel like it's more sanitized in this way. Wipe it up, and then chances are, with one this big, you have enough to wipe your hands up as well. Some people will walk into the bathroom and then go grab paper towels, wet it, bring it to the stall with them, use that to wipe their cup in their hands, and then leave. So under no set of circumstances do you as a person need to take your bloody cup out of a stall. Whoever happens to be in the bathroom is there. You don't have to wait until people leave and then, you know, sneak out and wash your cup in the sink. There's no circumstance where you have to do that in terms of cleanliness, in terms of, you know, safety. You can just put the cup right back in and wash it well when you get home. So it's not the nightmare scenario that most people have in their minds. You know, not to say there haven't been incidents where people have, you know, had a messy experience, especially when you're new. But overall, it's not that bad. And then the last advice I would have is you can also bring something like this if you have one of those big, huge purses, and you can just have this with you at all times, spray it, use toilet paper and clean it if you want, and you can also use it on your hands. It has alcohol, so it's also something that's disinfecting. So that's another option to consider. That's Hello Go, so it's like an on-the-go cleaner and it works on your hands. Let's talk about your monthly sanitation. So once a month, it's recommended that you boil your cup. Sanitize, whatever you want to call it. There's different things you can do. Boiling is free. I get asked all the time about these fancy electric cup sterilizers. I think that they're good and useful if you live in a space where you don't have a stove or where you have so many people in your household that, you know, it's uncomfortable for you to boil your cup. You know, you shouldn't be uncomfortable about it, but understandably not everyone wants to take the multi-generational household cooking pots and boil their menstrual cup. So everyone has their own comfort level. Another option would be these collapsible cup sterilizers. Sometimes cups come with them, the Tiute cup comes with it, and it's collapsible. You can keep it on you, stash it away, put it water in it, or you steam your cup basically with the microwave. This is great if you're in a communal living situation, dorm rooms, apartments, and it's just convenient. I've heard people say, okay, I live in a dorm, I don't even have a microwave, what do? Electric kettles, you can get that water going real hot, put your cup in a mug, and essentially pour the water over the cup in the mug. Same thing for Keurigs. I've heard people use Keurigs. So we've got a few options in that way. But let's talk about boiling. Use a whisk. So you put the cup in the whisk. What this does is it prevents the cup from scorching on the bottom of the pan. You would be amazed at how many people have ruined $30, $40 cups because they put it in a pot to boil and they just forgot about it because it's not like spaghetti. It's not like, I don't know, I don't cook. Whatever people put in pots that they cook, my husband cooks. So whatever that is, they forget about it. You can set a timer if you don't have a whisk, but I feel like most of us have a whisk. Even those of us who don't cook have a whisk. So that prevents it from scorching and also kind of keeps it under the water because, you know, they like to bob around in there. This really keeps it kind of in place. Lunette Cup recommends boiling for 20 minutes for the first time when you get a new cup. So if you want to keep it in the water for 20 minutes, you need this. I don't know why they ask for 20 minutes. I would boil every month or a brand new cup for at least 5-6 minutes. 20 minutes seems extreme, but if that makes you feel better, then boil it for 20 minutes. There's no harm in boiling it for 20 minutes. So better safe than sorry, right? Warning, I'm gonna show you a dirty stained cup, which is my dirty stained cup. You can skip ahead if you don't wanna see that, but this is a cup that has seen quite a bit of use. It's a clear cup, and you'll notice like it does get staining here on the under the rim. It, you know, tends to get staining around the grip rings. It stains more on the suction holes. And this is something that can easily be remedied with peroxide soak, and I'll show you that later. And then how often should we be stain removing? Probably gonna be like every 6 months or, you know, maybe even once a year. Frankly, I probably do it once a year on anything that's stained. And I can tell you, you know, this one hasn't been used in a while, but it probably has never been peroxide soaked. So this is 99 cents. This whole thing was 99 cents. Don't dilute the peroxide, just put it in a little thing and put your cup or your disc in the peroxide, your silicone product. I cannot begin to tell you what a miracle peroxide is. and it will magically remove the stains. And when I say magically, this particular disc was black. So it really did do magic. I soaked it for, I think, technically 4 hours. But what I did was I started, and I had to put a weight on it because I bought this recently. I had only a little bit of peroxide left. And so I had to use what I had. And I didn't have enough to really cover the whole thing. So I put a weight on it. And for that time period, I would come in and adjust it so that I wasn't missing a spot. And then after 2 hours, there was some buildup in spots I could see that wasn't getting soaked off. So I removed it and I took a soft towel and I just wiped it up and got any of the residue that was really stubborn that wasn't soaking off. And then I put it back in for another hour and then it came out looking like this. I can't even begin to tell you what a miracle this is. So that was wild. It really did. Soak this. I mean, this was black. I'm not kidding you. And I have the evidence to prove it. Smells fine. So occasionally people ask about smells. Try boiling your cup if it's accumulating some sort of smell that doesn't seem right to you. Menstrual cups really should not have a residual odor. So you definitely do want to look into the cause of that. One thing you can do is naturally disinfect the cup in sunlight. And I haven't tried it and done it before and after. I think that would be interesting, but there's no sun currently and it's winter. So I haven't been able to do it for this video, but I am interested. So maybe I'll do that another time. But put it at your windowsill and let it sit there for a few hours and see if the sun bleaches it out, or even put it outside and see if that helps with the smells. Don't just do random things. Definitely contact or read the brand's guidelines. The advice I'm giving you is based on what I do, and it has a lot of basis on what brands recommend. But you also should just look at your brand's website just to be sure you're not doing something that the brand itself says you shouldn't, because every brand has different guidelines. To close on this very ranty long video, properly every 12 hours cleaning your cup and washing it with either hot water or a cup safe cleanser, and then also sterilizing about once a month. But I would say it's probably recommended to boil and clean your cup once a month as a safety thing. It's safe. I've used a cup for almost 10 years, and not to say that you should just listen to me, but I have done all these things, washed without soap, washed with soap, gone a year without boiling, boiled it, everything was fine. There have been studies about TSS and properly washing your cup. All of those things are fine. You just don't want to leave your cup in too long. That's the danger for toxic shock syndrome, is leaving your cup in for far longer than the 12 hours. So definitely do what they say, remove and clean every 12 hours. Silicone is a medical grade product, so as long as you're caring for it properly, washing it properly, it's fine. If in your adventures you notice that the silicone is flaky, it's sticky, it's ripping, it has like micro tears, that's when it sounds like you need to replace your cup. That'll do it for this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you're new, make sure you subscribe. You can also find me on the Period Nirvana community, where I'm there answering questions along with other community members on Facebook. And if you're shopping for menstrual cups or menstrual cup wash or any of those things, if you shop with period.shop, which is www.period.shop, that is a way you can support the free educational content that I provide on YouTube and on Period Nirvana. So you're supporting educational efforts. And so if you've been helped by any of my videos and need a product, shopping with me over Amazon or some other website is much appreciated. And it's like true what they say about small business owners, that someone does a happy dance every time you do an order. It's literally true. So thanks for that, and thanks for supporting period.shop, and it means a lot that so many of you have been supporting so far. And if you want smaller little nuggets of education, I have caved and I finally joined TikTok. So you can find me on TikTok at Period Nirvana, where I'm doing all kinds of small menstrual cup and menstrual disc info videos and trying very hard. Look, I parted my hair in the middle and everything. So I am young at heart. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye. So it's
solid and it's got one little circle.
And it's recording now. It's recording for real. Bye. Love you.